Hello, Nutrition. Your textbook does a good job of describing the dietary reference intakes. You've got your estimated average requirements, your EARs. You have your recommended dietary allowances, your RDAs. You have your adequate intakes, your AIs, and your tolerable upper intake levels, the ULs. I want to take a few minutes to explain the relationship between these four values. The first thing you need to understand is that the DRIs are based around a population of healthy people. These values may not be perfectly matched for a single individual. Each person has their own nutrient requirements, and no two people are exactly identical. Your own personal nutrition requirements depend on genetics, age, environment, nutrition status, health, millions of different factors, different for every single person. It's impossible to know exactly what the nutritional needs are for any single individual, so we do the best we can by looking at the nutritional needs of the population as a whole. Now, let's graph out the nutritional needs of a population. Let's take a single nutrient, say vitamin A. On the x-axis, we have varying amounts of vitamin A. Our y-axis is going to be the number of people for whom that's the exact amount of vitamin A they need. A few people are down here at the low end. They don't need much vitamin A. They're fine with just a little bit. And a few people are up here at the high end. They really need a lot of vitamin A. But most people are somewhere in the middle. Maybe not the exact middle, but close. If you know statistics, this is a bell curve, a normal distribution. This line represents the nutritional requirements of our entire healthy population. The EAR is set here, in the middle. By definition, the EAR is enough to cover 50% of the healthy population. So if you're over here, you're fine if all you eat is the EAR. The trick is, you don't know where you are on this curve. You might be here, or even here, and if you only eat the EAR amount, you'll be deficient. The RDA is set higher. For statistics people, the RDA is the EAR plus two standard deviations. So the RDA covers about 98% of the healthy population. Now there's still a slim chance that you're on the tail end over here and the RDA isn't adequate for you, but for the vast majority of people, if they eat the RDA for a nutrient, they'll be just fine. The UL is the amount at which a nutrient becomes toxic. As the saying goes, the poison is in the dose, and you can have too much of a good thing. The UL is usually much, much higher than the RDA. For example, for vitamin A, the RDA for adult males is 900 micrograms per day. The UL for vitamin A is 3,000 micrograms per day. You'd have to eat three times the recommended dose in order to reach the toxic level. Because the UL is so much higher than the RDA, you're really not likely to reach it through food. However, if you take multiple supplements, you might actually reach the amount where a vitamin or mineral stops being good for you and starts damaging your body. Not all nutrients have a UL. Maybe a nutrient just isn't toxic, or maybe it is toxic, but at levels that no one ever consumes, so we don't know where the bar is. There's one last DRI I haven't mentioned yet, the AI. I can't show you where the AI is on this graph because the whole point of having the AI is to make a recommendation when we don't have enough information to draw this graph. The AI functions like the RDA, but for nutrients where there's just not enough information to calculate the EAR or the RDA. To determine the AI, researchers look at a population of healthy people and ask, how much of a nutrient do they generally get? So, the AI can still be used as a target amount for those nutrients which don't have an RDA, but it's not quite as scientifically rigorous as the RDA. As for using these DRIs, this is how it goes. We're looking at our intake amount of a particular nutrient. EAR is here. RDA, or AI, is here, higher. UL is all the way up here. If the amount you consume is down here, below the EAR, you're in danger of being deficient. If the amount you consume is here, above or close to the RDA or AI, you're safe. You're getting enough of that nutrient, but not too much. If the amount you consume is up here, over the UL, you're in danger again, this time of getting a toxic amount of the nutrient. One thing to remember is that these values are meant to be used as averages over time. It's okay if you don't get the RDA or AI of a nutrient every single day, as long as, over time, your intake averages out to at or above the recommended amount. So if you're a little low on vitamin A on Wednesday, just pack some carrots for lunch on Thursday.